up, everybody? My name is Brad, and welcome to episode one of The Short Stack, a new series here on the channel where I'm going to be giving my thoughts on and quickly reviewing different short stories I've read from short story collections and anthologies. For episode one, I'm going to be talking about Trash Fire Stories by Curtis M. Lawson from his collection called Devil's Night. This one is a really cool story. It takes place on Devil's Night in Detroit in 1987. We're following a young teenager named Clyde. He's in this abandoned car factory. You know, it's defunct. It doesn't operate anymore. He's doing graffiti. He's doing street art. He's painting this huge mural over this open doorway of what is called the Nyan Rouge, sort of an urban legend creature in Detroit. He's painting it up. He's there alone on Devil's Night. And then when he's about done, he gets interrupted by some other teenagers. He kind of sort of knows them, sort of friendly with them, kind of goes to school with them in a way. But these other kids, they're here to smoke weed, drink beer, you know, party like teenagers do on the night before Halloween. And they see this big mural that Clyde has been painting, and they get to talking about the creature of the subject matter, the Nyan Rouge. And so they sit around this trash can fire that Clyde had started earlier, and they start to tell stories about the Nyan Rouge and sort of their encounters with the creature. And suffice it to say, some of the stories have a bit more truth and a bit more bite to them than others. I don't want to say any more about the story. I like that it's sort of told in flashback. We're in the present day. They're sitting around the trash can fire telling what happened to them previously, sort of in flashback. And I like the folklore, urban legend aspects of the Nyan Rouge. I believe I'm saying it right. It's a creature that I've never heard of before, so it was cool to get some new knowledge or learn something new about a different type of creature. Again, it's sort of an urban legend in Detroit. A really cool story, great tone, creepy atmosphere, a great kickoff to the collection. This is episode one of The Short Stack, talking about Trash Can Fire Stories by Curtis M. Lawson from his collection Devil's Night. The Short Stack episode two. Today we're talking about the short story Dismal Dreams, the title track in the short story collection Dismal Dreams by Red Legault. This one we're following a guy, and he's fed up with life. He's tired of it. He has been married for a while, and his wife, she's sort of nagging. She tells him what to do. She plans out all of his free time away. He doesn't really get to choose what he wants to do anymore. On top of that, they have had a baby, and it's a baby he didn't really want. And the baby takes all any other free time that he might have had, takes that away. It's, you know, it seeks attention. It always needs attention. It's crying or whatnot. The wife, she's a good wife, but he just needs time away. He used to be outdoors all the time. He's got a boat he used to go out on. I guess he used to go fishing and whatnot. And he just wants to get away, but he can't. Every single minute of his life seems to be planned doing something else that he doesn't want to do. And it's just building up inside of him. This rage is going to reach a breaking point, a boiling point. It's cool. A fact in here, it says that back in the olden times, a dismal was a different name for a swamp. Hence the name Dismal Dreams. This one takes place in a swamp. I won't go any further in the story. Just say I felt his pain somewhat at sometimes. You know, I've got three kids and they do take your attention. They're attention drainers is what kids are. But, you know, I would never get to the point where he is, where he's just about to explode and about to lose it. And just say this story kicked off this collection with a bang. You know, Red Legault, she holds nothing back. She's not afraid to go to those dark places. I really enjoy this story. I've read her other collection, Lucid Screams. Really enjoyed that one as well. But Dismal Dreams is a great story to kick off the collection Dismal Dreams. This has been episode two of The Short Stack, talking about Dismal Dreams by Red Legault from her collection Dismal Dreams. Episode three of The Short Stack. Today we're in the Under Twin Suns anthology, talking about the story Robert Chambers Reads The King in Yellow by Lisa Morton. This was a cool fictionalized take on Robert Chambers and him writing the different stories he wrote regarding Carcosa and The King in Yellow. In the story, he's an author. He's got a first book out. It sort of flopped, didn't do too well. He's sort of struggling with book two. He's afraid it's going to flop as well. And then one night at midnight, he gets this knock on the door, and it's this mysterious kind of stranger. He looks really odd. He doesn't have any ears, but he has prosthetic ears on. He's missing all the fingers on one hand. Just an odd fellow. His cat, Robert Chambers' cat, is really scared of this guy. But he gives Robert Chambers this play, The King in Yellow, a play in two acts. He tells him to read it, and he wants Robert Chambers to write stories based on this play. Robert Chambers, he reads it, and it sort of drives him mad, sort of drives him a bit insane. He starts churning out these different stories, And each time the stranger comes to get a new story from Robert Chambers, he's gotten a little bit worse. His beard's all scraggly. His clothes are dirty and tattered. His studio apartment is just sort of in shambles. He's getting worse and worse, sort of diving slowly into this madness, into this insanity. And it's about the stories that Robert Chambers wrote in real life. I think there's four concerning the King in Yellow, the Mask. There's a couple others that I can't remember the name of. But I really like this fictionalized take on it. It was really cool. It sort of reminded me of the book Drood by Dan Simmons, which is about Charles Dickens and Wilkie Collins. Sort of had that same kind of vibe to it. I really dug it. I like it when you take historical figures and put a fictionalized twist on something that happened in their life that's sort of based on true events. A cool story. This is Robert Chambers Reads The King in Yellow by Lisa Morton from the anthology Under Twin Suns for episode 3 of The Short Stack. Episode 4 of The Short Stack. Today we're in The Strange Thing We Become and Other Dark Tales by Eric LaRocca, talking about the story You Follow Wherever They Go. This one was an odd little tale. I'd say it's subtle horror, quiet horror. We're following a young boy, and he's at home with his father. There's hints throughout the story that his father is kind of sickly, and I think they might be new to the area. I'm not sure, but the little boy, he doesn't really have any friends, and he sees some kids outside playing. It's raining outside. The kids are all dressed up in sort of paper mache costumes playing music. Sort of reminds me of the scene from the new Pet Sematary movie with the kids, you know, walking through the woods, playing the instruments and whatnot, sort of the funeral dirge. I don't think it's like that. It might be. I feel like this could be interpreted different ways. Anyway, the boy, he wants to make friends, but he's afraid to go out there. He's afraid they won't like him, that they'll make fun of him. He has a lisp. He's afraid they'll make fun of the lisp. And his dad's sort of encouraging him to go out there and make friends. You know, it's not going to be that bad. They won't, you know, be mean to you. They'll be nice. And sort of the father is wanting to put the son out there, knowing that the father is not always going to be around. Parents won't always be around to protect and love their children. One day, the children, whether they're younger or older, grown up, they're going to have to go out into life and do it on their own, make their own friends, form their own family, whatever they're going to do. It's sort of a story about that. And then the ending, I felt like I understood what happened. I think I know what happened, but it also could be maybe interpreted the opposite way. I don't want to say for sure and give anything away since it is a short story. Definitely read it for yourself. It was interesting. It was subtle. It was quiet horror. It was thought-provoking as well, being a parent, being a father, and you know, you want to hold on to your children and protect them as much as you can, but also you don't want to lock them down and not allow them to be free and express themselves and go out and make friends and go out and do things and maybe get hurt, but you don't want them to get hurt. Just, you know, adventuring and exploring life the way we did when we were younger. Cool story. It was You Follow Wherever They Go by Eric LaRocca from The Strange Thing We Become and Other Dark Tales for episode 4 of The Short Stack. Episode 5 of The Short Stack. Today we're in the anthology What One Wouldn't Do, edited by Scott J. Moses, and the story is called With Animals by J.A.W. McCarthy. I'm going to call her Jaw McCarthy. I think her name is Jen. I really, really dug the story. It was unique. It's a necromancy tale. Our main character, Ezra, he's a bit of a necromancer, and he's able to resurrect things, bring things back from the dead. He does it with animals and stuff. You know, roadkill, he finds it's not too badly off. He's able to bring it back to life. But whatever he brings back to life, it doesn't stay alive for very long. Maybe a couple days, maybe a week or so, maybe even a month if he's lucky. His friend Lou has passed away, so he's going to bring her back to life. Something bigger than he's ever done before. And when he brings something back to life, if there's anything living around them, it kills whatever's around them, sort of a life for life type situation. The first time he brings Lou back, it kills like 30 some odd seagulls at the beach. And like I said, once something comes back, it doesn't stay alive very long. So it's all about the sacrifices one would be willing to make for a few more minutes or hours or maybe even days with a loved one, with a friend. The toll it would take on someone that has that power, ability to bring someone back from death. I really dug this story. I thought it was going to be a lot darker than it was. It's still dark, but it actually had a sweet sort of ending, and I'm usually not down for that kind of ending, but this one really worked for me. I really dug this ending. I want to read more from J.A.W. McCarthy. It said she's got her own short story collection coming out sometime next year. I'm really looking forward to that one. Great story to kick off this anthology. This is a story With Animals by J.A.W. McCarthy from the anthology What One Wouldn't Do, edited by Scott J. Moses, This is episode 5 of The Short Stack.